students, today I am going to demonstrate an activity to show you how to connect an electrical circuit. The circuit that I have selected is an application of potentiometer, and in this application we determine the internal resistance of a primary cell using potentiometer. As you know, in any circuit connection, before you do the connection, the circuit diagram should be completely clear. Once you know the circuit diagram, it becomes very easy to connect the circuit. Once the circuit diagram is clear, then the next step will be to place each component of the circuit in proper manner in their respective places. Once they are placed in the right manner, then we start connecting them with the help of connecting wires. These are few steps to connect an electrical circuit. So the first step is you should understand the circuit diagram properly. So now I will explain you the circuit diagram which is required to determine the internal resistance of a primary cell using potentiometer. This is the circuit diagram to determine the internal resistance of a primary cell using potentiometer. Here, AB represents a 400 centimeter long potentiometer wire. V is the power supply connected across the wire AB with key K1 and the rheostat. It provides the required potential gradient to the potentiometer wire AB. The primary cell, having EMF E and internal resistance R, is shown in the diagram. The internal resistance of this primary cell is to be determined experimentally. S is the resistance box connected across the primary cell through key K2. The two terminals of the primary cell are considered as junctions as shown in the diagram. G is the galvanometer connected with a jockey. C and D are two positions of the jockey with K2 off and K2 on respectively. The ammeter shown in the diagram is to be connected while performing the actual experiment only to ensure the constant flow of current between the two observations of the balance length. The ammeter reading is not required in the determination of internal resistance. So, as you have understood the circuit diagram now, and you know the requirement of this circuit. So, as per the requirement, you can see that this is the rheostat. This is the battery eliminator which will play the role of supply. Here is the resistance box which is to be used parallel to our cell. And this is the cell, the Clanchi cell. Negative electrode which is zinc. Positive electrode which is carbon rod. Ammonium chloride solution. And this is the one-way key, galvanometer, the jockey, and the connecting wires. And here is the potentiometer which is to be used to assemble this circuit. Now, we'll place our components in the appropriate places. So, this is the potentiometer. These are two ends of the potentiometer wire, A and B. The rheostat is placed here. This is the supply. The galvanometer is placed somewhere here. These are our connecting wires. This is the jockey point. Here is the key. This is the cell, the Leclanche cell, and it is going to come parallel to this Leclanche cell. So this is how first you place all the components in the respective places. Once it is done, now you start connecting. Ensure that the ends of the connecting wire are clean. As you can see that the cottons are cleanly removed from the edges so that there is no obstruction when you are going to join the circuit. Now we'll start connecting the wires. From the positive terminal of the battery eliminator, I connect a wire at the point A.
From the negative terminal of the battery eliminator, I connect a wire at the upper terminal of the rheostat and tight it properly. And you can see that there is no separate switch K1 required in the circuit, because the switch of the battery eliminator will play the role of K1 in the circuit diagram. I take another wire, and that is to be connected from the lower terminal of the rheostat. From the lower terminal of the rheostat, so you can see that I'll simply make a hook. So don't keep wrapping the wire, make a hook and put it at the place and tight the screws. Similarly, here also I'll simply make a hook, put the hook like this and then tight the screw. Now since at these points A and B no other wire is going to come, at this point no wire is going to come, tight them properly. This I have not yet tightened properly because one more wire is to be connected here. So I take one more wire and connect it at the point A. When you connect, take both the wires together and make a hook and then tight the screw. So that gives the firmness to the wire. Now, the wire is going to be at the positive terminal of the rheostat. Here also, according to our diagram, there are two wires. So I take both the wires, take them together and make a hook and tight the screw. So this is the connection of the positive terminal of the Leclanché cell. This wire will go to the resistance box. Tight this one also properly. From the resistance box, we take the other end of the resistance box. From here, the wire comes to one-way key K2. Keep make the plug off and then tight them properly. Now take the wire for the other end of the key and join it with the negative terminal of the Leclanché cell. And according to our circuit, this point also is going to have two wires. So take both the wires together, both the wires together, and then fix them at the negative terminal of the Leclanché cell. This is not to be immersed in the ammonium chloride solution now. So you place it like this. The free end of one wire goes to the galvanometer. Jockey is now to be connected at the other end of the galvanometer. Tight them properly. And now you cross check once that all the terminals are tight. Also check that the plugs of the resistance boxes are also tight. So these are to be cross checked after you do the connection. So all the terminals now are to be tightened properly to see that there is no loose connection in the circuit. This completes our connection. That is, the circuit has been assembled as per the requirement. Now we'll test the circuit that we have assembled. So to do that, we first put the porous pot inside, which is having positive electrode. The negative also is inside the container, and so the Leclanché cell is now ready. We connect the source with battery eliminator. This is the switch K1, which is on, and now we expect that our circuit should give two-sided deflection in the galvanometer. So if the circuit is correctly joined, galvanometer should give me two-sided deflection when I touch at A and at B. So when I'm touching it at A, you can see that the deflection is towards left. When I'm touching at B, the deflection goes towards right. That means the circuit is correctly joined. Now I switch on K2 and take out 2 ohm resistance from the resistance box, and I check the two-sided deflection again. So at end A it is giving deflection towards left, at B it is giving deflection towards right. Hence the circuit is correctly joined, and both with K2 on and K2 off I am getting two-sided deflection in the circuit, and hence the circuit is correctly joined. This is how we have to assemble an electrical circuit. And while assembling a circuit, make sure that you are not using too many wires much longer in size. Also, you should ensure that the equipments, the apparatus, the components are placed at the appropriate place. Otherwise, you'll have to use unnecessarily long wires which will disturb our circuit. With this precautions in mind, you can connect any electrical circuit. So this is all about our demonstration experiment on assemble an electrical circuit. Thank you.